Hello, learners. Welcome to our management class. Today in our management class, we are going to look at the evolution of management theory. Now we are going to look at the contemporary, management theories. Under the contemporary management theories, we have contingency theory, we have systems theory, theory set, and management excellence. So I'd like us to start with the contingency theory. Contingency theory. This theory argues that appropriate management actions depend on the situation prevailing at the time. Contingency theory argues that appropriate management actions depend on the situations prevailing at the time. So according to this theory, there are no ready-made universal answers to management. Rather than the decision that a manager will make depends on the situation. So there's no automatic answer for a problem. It must be developed by the manager according to the situation. So every situation that a manager will confront will be somewhat different and therefore will require different reactions. Every situation that a manager will confront will be somewhat different and therefore will require different reactions. That's according to contingency theory. So according to the prevailing situations, you make decisions on that and then you come up with a reaction. Then systems theory. This theory tries to look at how organizations function and operate as a system that is a subsystem of a much bigger system. This theory tries to look at how organizations function and operate as a system that is a subsystem of a much bigger system. So it is the process by which an organization receives feedback. It is the process by which an organization receives feedback. So a system is an integrated set of elements that function as a whole. A system is an integrated set of elements that function as a whole. So it has four basic parts. Meaning it receives inputs from the environment. That's the system. It receives inputs from the environment. After receiving, it transforms the resources into output. That is finished goods. And then finally, receive feedback from the environment. So the feedback from the environment serves as a source of information about the performance of the firm, and hence it serves as a good basis for later decisions or decision making. Okay, so after receiving the input, you convert it to finished goods, then you receive feedback from the environment. The environment is now the outside organization, that's the market. So the feedback from the environment serves as a source of information about the performance of the firm or organization, so that you can know whether they are improving or not, for them to make decisions whether they are going to expand or to adjust. Then we have the all said. The all said management is a very new approach to management. So it has not yet withstood the test of time, and it is not certain, therefore, to evaluate into a fully developed theory of management. So this theory said management has some aspects. So some aspects of Japanese management. So in Japanese, managers place much more emphasis on generating harmony at all levels of the firm. So the Japanese managers, more than those from other cultures, to a great extent, they tend to place group goals ahead of the individual goals. And also, even if there is something to be rejected, Japanese managers rarely reject any contribution by subordinates. So they don't reject, they use them to make decisions. Then we have management excellence. This theory was advocated by Thomas Peters and Robert Waterman in the mid-80s. After studying various American films, they concluded that successful managers were characterized by 8 attributes according to management excellence. They said, to be a good manager, you must have the following characteristics. 1, a bias for action. Another one, staying close to the customer. You stay close to the customer so that you can serve the customer the right way. Another characteristic for a good manager, according to management excellence, is autonomy and entrepreneurship. You must have the characteristics of an entrepreneur and also autonomy. Productivity through people. You produce through people, so you show them how to produce so that you get the right quality and the right quantity for efficiency in an organization. Then we have hand-on value driven management. That is a quality or a characteristic of a good manager. And also we have many with the business. Stick to the knitting. Make sure in your mind you have your business, you have the firm, you have the objectives of the firm, not your individual objectives. Then symbol form and green staff. Make sure you are a symbol. Use symbol instructions to instruct your staff so that they can do whatever you tell them in the right manner. Then the climate of the dedication to the central values. Be dedicated to the central values, the main core objectives or core values of an organization. So because these theories have not been tested, the contingent theories have not been tested, and are still evolving, their validity cannot be ascertained. But they still do have useful information for managers of today's dynamic and complex organizations. So you cannot ignore these contingent management theories because they have more information for the managers. They are so much helpful to the managers. If the managers follow them, they can manage the organization in the right manner. So evolution theory, or the evolution of management thought, we have learned about the 3 schools and the contingents and the contemporary management theories. So in our next lesson, we are going to learn about planning function. We are going now to start learning about the functions of management. Let's meet then.